Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Are you confused by retinols? There's so much out there. Vitamin A derivatives, retinol, retinaldehyde, retinoic acid. What's that all about? There's a lot of confusion. I did a long video on the complete guide to retinols, but I wanted to give you a shorter clip on exactly what these are. If you want the full video, you can go to the description below under more info, and I'll leave a link at the end of the video as well. But let's dive into what these all are. So what is retinoic acid, retinaldehyde, retinol? Vitamin A is in the family of retinoids, another confused term. Think of it in terms of three common ingredients. In the retinoid family, you're going to have retinoic acid. That is the prescription version, and that many people have used that traditionally. That's the most potent, but many people either don't have access to it or they can't tolerate it, meaning that they want to use it a few times a week. It's drying out their skin, they get inflammation. But that's retinoic acid, biologically active. Then you go to the biologically inactives. These are the ones that you know. The first one is retinaldehyde. You do not hear of that one as commonly as you do retinol. So you have retinoic acid, which is the active form. The retinaldehyde needs to convert in one step to the retinoic acid in the body. And so many people would say, well, why wouldn't you use that? And one of the ones that I'm going to recommend at the end, in fact, is the retinaldehyde. I had in my skincare line a retinaldehyde. I liked it a lot. The only reason I stopped it, I just didn't have the capacity to work on that product line and packaging at the time. But the product was amazing. I still have the formulation. Love it. I think it's one of the best. And you'll see that come back into my line. But for now, I'll recommend a different one at the end. Retinol, which many of you then know, takes two steps to convert to retinoic acid. So it's less potent again, but more available. Why would that be? What's my take on that? With skincare, the less active products that a company puts in it, the less callbacks they get with problems, the less issues, and people just cruise on. Skincare is something that people buy different brands, they jump around. And if you have something active, as I'm gonna tell you in a few moments, there are problems with that, meaning sensitivity to the skin, skin flaking, redness, and that's what I'm here to answer for you today. So think of it in those three terms and it will make much more sense. The retinaldehyde and the retinols are not biologically active. They need to be converted. To confuse the situation a little bit more, people convert things by way of enzymes and so on at different rates. So while some people might not tolerate the retinaldehyde because it's closer to the retinoic acid, other people might need the retinol because it's even less potent. The bottom line is you can get the effect of the retinoic acid, the granddaddy, from both retinaldehyde and retinol. It might take a little longer, you might need a little more dose, but they're all very effective. Now, when I say they're effective, what does that mean? What do retinoids do? Well, when you hear the number of things, you're gonna wanna rush out and get one if you don't already have several lying around your house. Number one, reduce the look of fine lines and wrinkles. Who doesn't want that? Promote collagen growth. They decrease the appearance of the size of the pore. Why do I say it like that? You can't decrease the number of pores on your body, but pores become widened, they produce oil, and the exfoliating factor of retinoids can reduce the appearance of pores very effectively. They smooth the skin. They help treat acne and they kill P. acnes, a bacteria that leads to acne on the skin. They help with fine lines and they help reverse brown spots, solar spots. They give you glow. Everyone wants glass skin and glow. Why do I say that last? And the reason is, when we talk about glow, they will get you there, but initially they may not. They can cause problems in inflammation. That has to be addressed. So they can dull your skin too. And in this video, I'm going to tell you how to use them most effectively so you get glow. But they do that by improving light reflection, by giving you new skin, as the new skin typically turns over on the face every 30 days. Those that are on vitamin A derivatives, retinoids, they turn over the skin maybe every 13 to 17 days. So you're getting more and more skin as long as you follow my rules that will be forthcoming. So I put a link up here to my complete video on retinols. I hope you enjoy it. Subscribe, like this video, stay tuned here. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.